other situation, if it was any other situation, you would err on the side of caution. You have witnesses that say the girl converted 4 years ago. You have a MySpace page where her last login was May 6, 2007, where she is a Christian. This was in 2007, that was her last login. There's absolute proof that she was a Christian. So the brainwashing and the cult status assigned to Christianity is really particularly disgusting. There's proof that she was abused. There's proof that she was threatened, physically threatened. You have a pastor speaking about, for at least a year, the threats made against this girl's life. This is a no-brainer. We don't have to have a conversation about apostasy, although we should. We're not going to have that conversation.
Ma'am, there is no proof. The Ohio Department of Families has already concluded there's no proof that she ought to go back home.
Well, if you want to discuss the corrupt Ohio Department of Families, I'm happy to do it. Listen, they did not, did you? You know, she spoke to 20 people during the past year. 20 people.
Let's finish.
Columbus, Ohio police don't have any evidence.
She told 20. I'll give you the names.
Why don't we do their work?
Law enforcement's investigating. They already cleared
it. Yeah, but sometimes we have to do the work.
Talk to them. We'll finish. We'll open it up for questions.
All I'm saying is that there are no questions.
21 years old is not capable of making her own mind.
Anyway. Her brain is fully formed. She knows she's in trouble. And the thing is that with these Western girls, like Amina and Sarah Saeed and Aksa Parks, like Amina and Sarah, I'm friendly with the family of the Christian side of the family of Amina and Sarah Saeed and Aksa Parvis. These girls lead Western lives outside in the school. They do soccer, they do tennis, they do AP classes. When they go home, it's a different story. And when do they get killed? They get killed when the parent loses control. When Amina and Sarah ran away, the mother lured them back. Within 24 hours, they were dead. When Aksa Parvis left home and they lured her back home, she was dead. This girl, they found out her conversion was complete. The bags were packed. The father was coming home. She called up these people she didn't know. She said, please take me in. How could this not appeal to the basic humanity in you? Forget your political correctness for a second. Your basic humanity in you.
It's the legal system. It's corrupt in Ohio.
We can address everything. We make no apologies for the passion involved on both sides. The gentleman has his viewpoint. That's fine. We're establishing two things. That there's a timeline here which shows that Rifqa Bary is not being brainwashed in Florida, A, so she must stay. That's point number one. Point number two, Robert has laid out, the evidence is there, the documents are there for consideration, that this mosque is very, very dangerous. John Stemberger, Rifqa's attorney, put the report together on the Noor Mosque, put it out to the public, and ought not be punished for revealing documented information about this organization. So if the three of you folks can come back up.
Robert, can I ask you about the mosque in particular? Because I spoke
Robert
to the FBI yesterday.
All right.